Morning, guys. We're here at Chatfield Reservoir State Park, Chatfield State Park in Colorado. We're about 10 miles from Denver, and hoping to do some good old-fashioned POTA activity today. It's really blustery wind today. In fact, I didn't use the ground spike today on my pack 10 and 10. I actually used a tripod, and I'll show you this. If you buy a tripod that you can take the ball head off of, what's left is a 3/8 16 tap. The Pac-10 antenna is a 3/8 16 adapted antenna, and so it screws right on. And then mine, as you can see, I can open up these legs right flat to the ground, and so I have this thing straight up here in this pretty high wind right now. Well, if you guys can hear me above all this crazy wind, the wind's so crazy, it's actually shaking this gazebo thing, this little picnic table with a roof on it. And it's actually a metal structure, but it's shaking, and it's shaking everything. I've already had my antenna get knocked over once from the wind. It's a crazy day. But so I don't think I mentioned this in the last thing, but I really dedicated myself to wanting to learn CW, learning Morse code. And I found the only way to do that is not unlike going to another country and just to learn their language, just complete immersion. So I just decided I'm just not going to do any kind of parks on the air activations or summits on the air activations with anything but CW. That's the only mode I'm going to use. And that way, at some point, because I really love going out and doing this stuff, and while learning Morse code and stuff is a struggle, like this is the only way I'm going to figure out how to do this. If I just come out here and do it over and over again, I'm gonna learn Morse code really good, I think. I hope, anyway. So, anyway, my practice sessions this last few days have been awesome. And this is actually my third activation, not my second. I know I was gonna do one video every activation, but I brought my camera out and the battery was dead. And so I was just screwed and there was nothing I could do about it. So, anyway, without further ado here, they plug in the power cord so this doesn't happen again. All right. And let's make some contact. This, like, the wind's so strong, I have to keep my phone right here. And because it blew this off the table already once. So, all right, here we go. CQ POTA. See if we're spotted here. I love this reverse beacon network thing, man. Best who ever thought of that? Amazing. right, that's three. That one was a little better. That was better. Like, I've had worse. Having this right here, I wrote it down, my response, and I can translate that faster than trying to think of everything to say and translate it. And I can be real careful not to grab onto this pin right here, because it fires. You know, as hard as this is, I'm still having a really good time. So I don't want you guys to get the wrong idea, because I'm over here like getting upset with myself for sending terrible Morse code. I'm having a great time. It's fun learning. This is like the best kind of learning, is immersing yourself in CW. No phone, no SSP, no AM, no nothing until I get this down. Nothing but SSP until we get there. Come on, guys, I need you. I need all of you. I wish I'd gone to a place. I might have to move. I might have to go someplace with a tree and throw up an end fed. I was kind of hesitating doing that only because of the wind. I don't want to break my wire. But at the same time, I think my end fed will do better in this vertical, because I'm just not getting out. I'm gonna adjust my radials and see if that makes a difference. See if that makes this a little more directional. You put the radials away from the direction you want to DX to. Generally, that kind of makes it more directional in that direction. I don't know if that's the truth or not. I did get a reverse beacon network in Canada. I don't know if you guys can see that or not. So I'm getting out. Oh, someone's tuning up on me, I think. California. Okay, four out of California. Thank you, guys. Let's keep going here. We only need six more. Winds come down just slightly. It's supposed to snow this evening here in Colorado. It's October 20 something. Whoa,
dotted, dotted.
Okay, got it. Okay. right, that's three. That one was a little better. That was better. Like, I've had worse. Having this right here, I wrote it down, my response, and I can translate that faster than trying to think of everything to say and translate it. I gotta be real careful not to grab onto this pin right here, because it fires. You know, as hard as this is, I'm still having a really good time. So I don't want you guys to get the wrong idea, because I'm over here like getting upset with myself for sending terrible Morse code. I'm having a great time. It's fun learning. This is like the best kind of learning, is immersing yourself in CW. No phone, no SSP, no AM, no nothing until I get this down. Nothing but SSP until we get there. Come on, guys, I need you. I need all of you. I wish I'd gone to a place. I might have to move. I might have to go down someplace with a tree and throw up an end fed. I was kind of hesitating doing that only because of the wind. I don't want to break my wire. But at the same time, I think my end fed will do better in this vertical, because I'm just not getting out. I'm gonna adjust my radials and see if that makes a difference. See if that makes this a little more directional. You put the radials away from the direction you want to DX to. Generally, that kind of makes it more directional in that direction. I don't know if that's the truth or not. I did get a reverse beacon network in Canada. I don't know if you guys can see that or not. So I'm getting out. Oh, someone's tuning up on me, I think. California. Okay, four out of California. Thank you, guys. Let's keep going here. We only need six more. Winds come down just slightly. It's supposed to snow this evening here in Colorado. It's October 20 something. Whoa,
dotted, dotted.
Okay, got it. Okay. Jesus. Thank you. Oh, the nerves. I got it. K5VWW. Nevada. Arizona. That's work. I love it. Let's do some more. We're activated at 11 at this point, but oh my God, this has been a lot of work though. We'll get one more. Then we'll get out of here. Gotcha. NE, Nebraska. That guy sounded like he was struggling like I am. It's cool to see other people out there that are just trying. And, someday when I'm really proficient, I swear to God, I'm going to give these people the time of day. I really am, because I know what they're going through right now. Oh my God. right now my mind can do the POTA protocol, I guess you will, of a contact really easily. But when they go off script, it's really hard to follow them, especially if they have any key speed whatsoever. And it, oh my gosh, it's so hard. Only way we're gonna get better at this is we have to slog through the trenches together. Well, I also got to slow down, and then he went away. That's a shame. I mean, maybe he faded out, but how many times could people fade out today, honestly? Thank you. Illinois. People that use a straight key, it's like they have a really thick accent, and it's so much different than a keyer unless the person's really right on. And so it makes it that much more difficult to copy them when they have that accent, if you will. What, I don't know, they call it thick-fisted or something. Get my stove set up here, warm up a little bit. That wind took it right out of me. It was too windy to make coffee earlier. Man, I don't know if I'm gonna hear this guy. Going out. I need to get a windproof one, I swear to God. like someone's tuning up on me. I can't even get this lid. I can't make coffee today. Oh my God, this wind. This is why we call it hard comms. Oh my God, this is really something. I'm gonna get a jet boil. I'm gonna go get one right after this, I swear. Fury. You can hardly hear the radio. White caps on the lake right now. I can't believe there's boats out there. This is like 30 mile, 35 mile an hour winds, 40 mile an hour gusts. I'm trying to get one more and then we're gonna bug out because I can't even hear the radio. Normally I would use headphones. And I got a little recorder, but I have to get a special adapter from this particular radio to the recorder. No one can record off this radio, but I think I figured out why. It'd be nice to have headphones on. I can still talk to you guys, but you'll hear this, and I can hear this. However, I'll say that my copy was a little better today. It wasn't great, but it was better. Shaking me. Okay. Okay, that's it. So, what have we learned today? It's hard to activate the wind. We definitely learned that today. I think what comes out of this is a sense of accomplishment as well as confidence. People generally slow down for me. It was really nice, and they weren't hesitant to repeat. However, there was like three contacts today that made contact with me and then left. Now, potentially, they, wow, potentially, they, I faded out on them, potentially. Conditions weren't that great for me today, but, I don't know. I do know that someday when I'm fluent in this, which is going to be in a few months, because I'm just going to keep activating with just CW, but I'm hoping that someday when I do this, I will give the people